by the comfort wherewith we ourselves are comforted of God. For as the sufferings of Christ abound in us, so our consolation also aboundeth by Christ. And whether we be afflicted, it is for your consolation and salvation, which is effectual in the enduring of the same sufferings, which we also suffer. Or whether we be comforted, it is for your consolation and salvation, and our hope of you is steadfast.
I hope
our partakers
still
of the
have enough voice on this.
So shall you be also of the constellation.
I was fishing a few weeks ago,
and one of the elders answered, saying unto me, what are these which are arrayed in white robes? And whence came they? And I said unto him, stop, sir, thou knowest. And he said to me, these are they which came out of great tribulation, and have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. Therefore are they before the throne of God, and serve him day and night in his temple. And he that sitteth on the throne shall dwell among them. They shall hunger no more, neither thirst any more. Neither shall the sun light on them, nor any need. For the Lamb which is in the midst of the throne shall feed them and shall lead them unto living foundations and waters. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes.
Thank you.
that you can live any kind of way. Name is on the church book, and I've got heaven secure. One day, we must all stand before the judgment seat of Christ. And I got news for you. Even that thing done in the dark, and you thought didn't nobody see it, I want you to know you're right there. You're going to be there. Come on, tell three people your record and my record. We'll be there.
I can remember as a child back in Liberty, Texas at 131 Navigation Street at my grandmother's house. Mamie Sip Baldwin. Mama is what we called her. And I can remember on Sunday mornings, if you were in Mama's house, you had to get up for Sunday morning prayer. Come to think of it, if you in my mama's house today on Sunday morning, you got to get up for Sunday morning prayer. And my grandmother knew how to pray. She had a lot of grandsons, and oftentimes she couldn't think of our names, and sometimes she would just call us all Bubba. And I got some of my first cousins in here and my brothers in here witness to that. But it was something about when Mama got down on her knees to pray for us, she could remember all of our names. And there was nothing like that Sunday morning devotion there. And today we want to remember how Mama used to pray for us. Come on, choir, help me sing. I still hear.
Mama praying.
I still hear.
Mama praying.
And the prayers that she prayed.
The prayers that she prayed.
That's still keeping me.
Day by day.
I still hear mama praying. Can I get a witness in the building? I still hear.
Pray.
trust our Lord. Oh, she prayed for the Lord to bless and keep her children. Sheets I laid in with my wine and sheet. I want to thank you for letting my moment roll on a little while longer. You were there for me, and I can say never would have made it, never could have made it without you. I would have lost it all, but now I see how you were there for me, and I can say I'm stronger, I'm wiser, I'm better, much better. When I look back over all you brought me through, I can see that you were the one I held on to, and I never,
never would have made it.
Oh, I never could have made it.
Never could have made it.
Yeah.
somebody just need to testify to somebody next to him. Tell him, I'm strong. I'm wiser. I'm better. Much better. I made it. Is there anybody in this house other than me that can declare you made it? Tell your neighbor, never would have made it.
Never would have made it.
Tell them, never could have made it.
Never could have made
Well, let's stand on our feet and thank God for a soldier that fought a good fight, who lived a wonderful life. Come on, stand to your feet, put your hands together. We're here because Mama Josephine lived, not because she died. Come on, let's celebrate her life. You can do better than that. Come on, put your hands together. Let's celebrate. 93 years. 23 years in overtime. We are plumbers, 3 score and 10, which is 70. But God thought enough of you all to give her 23 additional years on this earth. Come on, let's give God praise. 93 years. Come on. Wonderful. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. We're going to follow the program as printed. We thank God for our brother, Brother Steve Jenkins, who's our funeral director for the day. We appreciate his presence in the rear. And at this time, we shall have Old and New Testament scripture and prayer. And then we will have a selection by Sister Benita. And then we'll have acknowledgments and resolutions. And after that, we'll have another selection, and then I'll come back before you. Amen.
Our Old Testament scripture will come from Ecclesiastes, the 3rd chapter, starting with the 1st verse. To everything there is a season and a time to every purpose under the heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing, and a time to get and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to cast away, a time to rend and a time to sow, a time to keep silence and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time of war and a time of peace. I've read the 1st 8 verses in the 3rd division of Ecclesiastes. Our New Testament scripture will come from St. John's, the 14th chapter, starting with the verse 1 through 6. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions, and if it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you, and if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whether I go, ye know, and the way ye know. Thomas saith unto him, Lord, we know not whither thou goest, and how can we know the way? Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. And God's word is already blessed. Most holy and righteous Father, we come before you this morning as humble as we know how, giving you all the honor, the glory, and the praise, coming on behalf of the family of Mother Josephine Haston. Father, we come praying that you would give them comfort and peace and let them know that weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. We know the sorrow that they're feeling, Father, because if we had a choice, we would live forever. But we understand, Father, in the by and by, one day you're going to call all your children home, and it will be one hallelujah good time. No more pain, no more suffering. So, Father, we pray for the peace right now and the comfort, and let them remember the joyful time that they've had. In Jesus' name, amen.
Why should I feel discouraged and why should the shadows come and why should my His tender word I hear, resting on His goodness, I lose my doubt. Sing because I'm happy, and I sing because I am free. Oh, I sing because I am free. Yes, well, His eye is on the sparrow. Yes, the sparrow. And I know He watches over me. Yes, well, I sing because sing, because I am free. Yes, well, His eye is on the sparrow. Yes, the sparrow, and I know. Yes, I know. Yes, I know. Yes, I know. No doubt about it. Yes, I know. Yes, I know. He watches me. Yes, I know. He watches me. Yes, I know. He watches me. Yes, I know. He watches over me. Hallelujah.
Fully express our heartfelt appreciation for the sympathy, love, and support you have extended to our family during the loss of our loved one. May God bless and keep you. With Pastor Veal and the Temple Baptist Church family, also known as the Great Big Family, please stand. Church resolution for Mother Josephine Haston. No matter what your trials are or how big your mountain seems, the Lord is there to see you through. He'll go to all extremes. So if your cross seems hard to bear and you know not what to do, the one who loves you most of all will be there to see you through. We are in place in this world for a limited time, and with the breath of the infant begins the race to the grave, a race everyone must run. Whereas in the providence of God, He has brought to a close the life of Mother Josephine Haston. On behalf of Pastor Sedric D Veal Sr, Adults with Seniority Senior Ministry, Parent AWS, Mission Ministry, Mother's Ministry, Noonday Bible Class, Sanctuary Servants 2, Sunday School, and the entire membership of the Temple Baptist Church, we feel that it is befitting to express our sympathy to the Haston family during the passing of your mother and grandmother. We commend you to Him who knoweth best and will always do right. You have our sincere prayers. Be it resolved that we bow in humble submission to Him who never makes a mistake, and remind the family to be encouraged by casting all your cares upon Him, for He careth for you, 1 Peter 5:7. Be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution will be given to the family, and a copy will be kept in the church archives. To the family, we know your loss is deep and your sorrow is great, but we want you to know that we share in your sorrow. Humbly submitted on this first day of April, 2023, the officers, AWS, Mission Ministry, Mother's Ministry, Noonday Bible Class, Sanctuary Servants 2, Sunday School, and members of the Temple Baptist Church, East Cleveland, Ohio, Sedric D. Veal Sr., Lead Servant. On behalf of Pastor Veal and the Temple Baptist Church, we would like to present this memorial Bible to the Haston family.
God bless you. Thank you so much. At this time, we're going to have Sister Kristen, Ashley, and Brother Leon. If you'll come to the stage, and they will give their presentation. Then once you have finished, you can go back to your seat, and then Sister Benita will come with the final song. Amen. Let's give them a hand as they come.
Pastor Veal, good morning to my family. Good morning, Temple Baptist Church. There are so many things I want to tell you about my grandmother. In the interest of time, I will tell you about my summers. When I was a child, I spent just about every summer, Christmas break, just about any time I had off of school in Cleveland with my grandparents. I cannot stress to you enough how these were some of the best and happiest days of my life. Grandma cooked every single day. I have missed her cooking for so many years now. Sometimes she would fry chicken and put it on a bun with a pickle and tell me, "Now see, that's better than Chick-fil-A." When McDonald's had the little plastic Barbie dolls as Happy Meal toys, we would drive all around town to go to different McDonald's so I could collect them all. It didn't matter which one. I mean, we drove all over the city, even to the west side. The only one we didn't go to was the one on Superior. We weren't allowed to eat at that McDonald's. When we reached the window, Granddaddy would hand me the Happy Meal box, and Grandma would turn around in her seat excitedly to watch me open it. "Which one did we get? Is it a new one?" She was just as invested as me. On Wednesdays, we went to Bible class. Sister Rice was the teacher, and I took notes. "Write that down," Grandma would say. And on Sundays, we went to Temple Baptist Church. She would proudly take me around to all of her friends and introduce me. "This is my grandbaby. She's staying with me for the summer." The other thing that we had to do was attend the street club meetings on Castlewood. She took turns. We took turns walking to Miss Osborne, Miss Foster, or Miss Allison's house. I can recall one meeting. It was either 92 or 93, but the song "Whoop, There It Is" was very popular. And just about every time somebody said something or made a point, Grandma would point at them and say, "Whoop, there it is." At nighttime, we'd get in bed and we'd watch Thea and Love Connection every night. We had so much fun trying to guess if the couples would go on a second date or go their separate ways. And I know I'm talking about summer, but I would be remiss if I didn't tell you about Christmas mornings, because Grandma made everything so much fun. On Christmas mornings, she was Santa Claus's personal hype woman. She would exclaim happily, "Ooh, look at this. Ooh, look at that. Santa Claus been here." But alas, when summer came to an end, it was time for me to return home. Grandma and Granddaddy always took me shopping to get new school clothes. They'd say, "Pick out whatever you want." They were the best. These are the things that I remember and the memories that I will cherish all the days of my life. I love you, Grandma. I've been missing you for a long time because we haven't been able to talk like we used to. And I always remember our special summers together. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. I'm Ashley for y'all. Well, y'all know me, of course. So, man, I have so many memories of Grandma. So if y'all can bear with me, it might be a little difficult. But one of my favorite memories is when she used to tell me about when she first found out about me. She always would say, "Well, your daddy brought you to me and put you in my arms and you were 6 weeks old." And I said, "Fuji, who baby is this?" And he would say, "Mine." "And who the mama?" "Teresa." And then she said, "Oh, Haston, Fuji done got a baby." She loved to tell me that story. And I said, "Grandma, tell me the story again," when I was little. I lived with Grandma and Dada, her husband, artist, until I was 14 years old. Just so many memories, and I'm so thankful for everything and all the lessons she taught me. And also the timeless sayings. If you were looking good, she would say, "Ka, ka, ka." And if you said something she didn't agree with, she would say, "If you think so, but not..." There you go. Oh, man. She kept me very active in this very church. I was baptized by Pastor Veal, and I'm so thankful that we were able to get her back home to her home church. I was active in just about everything that the church had to offer, and it just helped develop me into the woman I am today. And one of the many things that I appreciated about my grandma and also my grandpa was that she showed up for me no matter what, whether that was volunteering for every single school event there was, or being there for me during a tough time. Well, when I moved to Georgia, I didn't want to leave them. I was there for my whole life, but, you know, I did. And it was a tough transition, having to meet new friends, go to a new high school. But she sent me care packages and handwritten notes of all my favorite snacks that they didn't sell back in Georgia. The Snyder's Chips barbecue, I love those so much, and she would pack them all up and send them to me. Even though my grandpa wasn't well, he would drive her everywhere and take her to ship those to me. And those handwritten notes, I kept as many as I can, and I'm so grateful I still have them to this day. Although it's hard to say goodbye, I'm so grateful to know that I have had almost 31 years with her. And also now she's at peace and with the love of her life, Dada. So Grandma, I love you. I'll always remember you. I'm so thankful for you. And yeah, you'll stay with me forever. Thank y'all.
Good morning. My name is Leon Agnew. Josephine Haston was my grandmother, so I'm a grandson. First, I want to thank everyone for coming. Also, thank Pastor Veal for pulling us all together at such short notice. Just things just seemed to come together when we got in touch with you. And I don't know what you said to my mother, but everyone knows my mother is a devout Catholic, and she mentioned to me she may consider converting, so you did a great job. This is kind of interesting because around 1977, 78, I actually went to this school. This is school here, this campus here. I actually went to kindergarten through third grade, myself, my friend Robert, and my sister Kim. So somewhat of a homecoming, from that respect. And I recall a time when my grandmother had to recite a Bible verse for his part of class, and my grandmother helped me stay up all night, and the next morning I did recite it well, and she was just so proud of me, because we had studied that. I can't remember exactly what it was, but my mother probably knows. But I never had an opportunity to actually speak on the stage because I was so young. It's pretty, I don't know, some 40 plus years later that I'm here giving, a tribute in her honor. Maybe there's some irony somewhere in that, I don't know. But my grandmother was very special to me. We had a very special bond. When I was born, what she would tell me when I was born, that she would always remind me that she was the first person to ever see me in the world. And that was kind of our little special, one of our special things of many. My sisters, more specifically, I remember my sister Kim, she would tease me and say that, you know you're her favorite. And I don't know if I was or not, but she always made me feel that way. My grandmother had a very unique touch that made you feel good about yourself. And judging from all the folks that are here today, and I imagine that everyone had a special relationship or a moment that they've shared with her in some regard, in the most loving and positive way. So I'll miss her, of course. We all will. But I gotta know that she's in a much, much better place. So we'll move on. We won't forget her. And I'm just so grateful that, I had her part of my life. Thank you all. Thank you.
in your word. Please order my steps in your word. Humbly I ask you, teach me your will. While you are working, help me be still. Though Satan is busy, God is real. Order my steps in your word. Order my steps in your word. Bridle my tongue, let your words edify. Let the words of my mouth be acceptable in thy sight. Take charge of my thoughts, Lord, day and night. Please order my steps in your word. Yes, please order my steps in your word. Order my steps in your word, dear Lord. Lead me, guide me every day. Send your anointing, Father, I pray. Please order my steps in your word. Please order my steps in your word. I want to walk worthy. Yes, I do, Lord. My calling to fulfill. Please order my steps, Lord, yes. And I'll do your blessed will. The world is ever changing. Yes, it is, Lord. But you remain the same. If you order my steps, I'll praise your name. Yeah, Lord, I want to walk worthy, Lord. Yes, I do. My calling to fulfill. Please order my steps, Lord. Yes, and I'll do your blessed will. The world is ever changing. Yes, it is. But you remain the same. If you order my steps, I'll praise your name. Yes. Order my steps in your word. Order my tongue, Lord, yes, in your word. Order my feet in your word, Lord. Wash my heart in your word. Show me how to walk, Lord, in your word. Show me how to talk, Lord, in your word. When I need a brand new song to sing. Show me how to let your praises ring in your word. Yes, in your word, Lord. Please order my steps in your word. Please order my steps in your word. Order my steps in your word. Order my tongue in your word. Guide my feet in your word. Wash my heart in your word. Show me how to walk, Lord, in your word. Show me how to talk, Lord, in your word. When I need a brand new song to sing, Lord, show me how to let your praises ring, Lord, in your word. Yes, hallelujah, in your word. steps in your word. Please order my steps in your word. Please order my steps in your word. Please order my steps in your word.
Wonderful. Give the Lord another hand clap of praise. Again, we are here to celebrate the life of our dear sister, and certainly she was loved by so many, and we're thankful to this family for allowing her to share so many hours at Temple with us. And certainly she had a big heart, and she had a love and a care for me. For most of my babies, she held herself. She was head of a pastor's aid ministry, took care of me for many years. And her husband, he was the drop-off man. He would bring me, when I see him coming to me, I know I was about to get some food, some cake and some fried chicken. And if there was an evening program, I didn't have to worry about food. She was going to make sure I was taken care of. And I'm just so appreciative for Mama Haston. And it's interesting, about a month or so ago, she fell on my mind. And I asked him, how is she doing? And so I'm just appreciative for the life, and to see that when I moved here, she took care of me, and then in her death, I get a chance to take care of her. And to see those that went to school here, and then it's interesting how the Lord moved the church here to this section of town. And so we're just so thankful for her life and the life that she lived. And she certainly has done a tremendous job in being who she is. Let's give God another hand clap of praise. Aristotle says that we either fight through it or we die in it. I don't believe 93 years on this earth that she lived, I don't believe God gave her 93 years without some battles. Sheep are dependent and they have a special devotion to the shepherd. When sheep are in the pasture, sheep are able to mingle and mix with other sheep, but then there comes a time when the sheep has to have some shepherd time. And there's been times in your life that as sheep, those of us who are saved, we are sheep in the fold, we've had time with others, but now it's time for you to have some time with the shepherd. Because there are certain things that sheep can't help you get out of, but the shepherd can. And so there's a lot of certainty amidst the uncertainty. We are here because it looked like death wins, but does death really win? Is God still in charge? Is God still in control? Well, when you rely on other sheep, they may have questions like that, because when you're going through situations like death, it has a way of shaking your foundation. It shakes your faith because you're praying for God to stop the hand of death, but then God lets death reign for the moment. So then the question becomes, and I'll be through here in just a second, the question becomes, well, where is God in all this? What is God doing? How is God managing things? Well, I need to tell you that, child of God, while you are trying to monitor the movements of God, God is monitoring the movements of you. He wants to make sure that you understand, first of all, that he's never absent. God is always there. He's with you right now. Even though there are times you may not see him, he is with you. His presence is always with you and is there on the memorial blanket. It says, the Lord is my shepherd and I shall not want. And I believe that's what Mama Haston would have me to say to you today, that if you're going to make that declaration, you get to a point in life that God is all you have and God is all you need, then your want list, it starts decreasing. Because when you find out who God is and you declare that he's my everything, then you don't have to worry about anything. So then I go back to my question, where is God in all this? Well, the fact that David says in verse 1, he says, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. First of all, David declares that the Lord is before me. You need to understand, child of God, that God is already in a position to handle any problem before any problem occurs. He's before us. Listen to what he says. When you get home, you'll want to read Psalms 23. I believe L-O-R-D is in all caps, which literally means David uses a special word. This Yahweh is in Hebrew script has no vowels, and the Hebrew Bible is pronounced Yahweh, Jehovah, in the English translation, which means that he's the self-existent one, which means that the one that is before me is the great I am, which means that if you trust him as the great I am, you don't have to worry about what's not, because God is already in position to handle anything that will happen in your life. Matter of fact, he's already made provisions for you, and it's right here, it's plain, and I believe she will have me to say this to you. Listen at what he says. He's Jehovah Rohi, he's my shepherd. That's in verse 1. He's Jehovah Jireh. He's the Lord our provider. He says, I shall not want. The Lord is my peace. He's Jehovah Shalom in verse 2. In verse 3, he's Jehovah Rapha. He's the Lord that healeth us because he says he restoreth my soul. He's Jehovah Tsikanu in verse 3, the Lord our righteousness. He's Jehovah Shammai in verse 4, the Lord is there. He's Jehovah Nissi in verse 5, the Lord is our banner. Here it is, child of God. He's Jehovah El Elyon, the Lord Most High in verse 6, because he talks about how he follows me. God is everything you need in every verse, every scripture, every sentence of your life. He's already in position to say, I am the one that will take care of you. Well, if you still don't believe it, he says, I offer you rest. He says, I make you lie down, because there are going to be times that sheep get weary and you need some revitalization. He says, he leads me beside the still waters. That's a metaphor for a resting place. And the water is a symbol for refreshing and then quiet waters. You see, sheep, the way their throats are constructed, sheep cannot drink from rushing waters because they would choke. But yet he sends them to quiet waters where they can drink and relax. And that's what God will do. That's the God we serve. That's the God she trusted. She says, God, I trust you. But then there are times that God says, Sister Josephine, can I trust you with trouble? She says, well, it's not my trouble, Lord. If you sign off on it, I'm going to trust it to give it back to you and trust that you'll make a way out of no way, because I've discovered that you're already in position. I think I read in her obituary, First Baptist Church down there in Alabama, I believe I read that. She trusted in God from an early age and then pass it on to her grandchildren and pass it on to her children to have them to understand that if you're going to make it through a dark time like this, you got to have God before you. But then, where's God when it gets tough? Well, God says, you're monitoring my movements, but I'm monitoring yours, because sometimes you start moving forward and you're without direction, and then there are other times you get distracted. It's right there in verse 4, and I'm done. He says, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, watch what he says, I'll fear no evil, because the Lord is with me. Thou art with me. Where is God? Well, God says, I'm before you have trouble. But when you mess around and get in trouble, he said, I'll be beside you. He says, yea, though I walk through. You see, verse 4 is interesting because, you see, verse 4 shows us that there are times in your life that you got to move from talking about him to talking to him. Matter of fact, they used to say down south, just a little talk with Jesus would make everything all right, because when life and loads and limitations will push you to the point to where you just don't talk about him, but you have to talk to him. You have to say, Lord, help me. Lord, it's too much for me. Lord, I stretch my hand to thee. No other help I know. God, you got to come through for me. 93 years, I believe she had to trust in God, and she had the kind of faith that would suggest that if I talk to God, he'll make things better. And I don't know what you're going through today. It don't have to just be death. Whatever situation you're dealing with, you can understand that you can talk with God. And I believe that some of you had to pray lately. And your prayer don't have to be long. It don't have to be flowery language. You can just say, Lord. You can just say, help. You can just say, mercy. It don't have to be long. You don't have to impress anybody else with your language. You can just talk with God, and God will hear your cry. And some people are afraid to pray because they suggest that I'm not as educated as others. Well, the story is told from down south that there was this southern lady who didn't get any further than third English. Those of you from down third grader from down south, you understand what that means, third English. You will understand. She would get up and they would pick on her to pray because they wanted to make fun of her. And every time she would stand up to pray, she would just look up, but she wouldn't say nothing. And everybody in the church would just fall out. They thought that was just a hilarious thing because they felt that she didn't know her prayers. Every Sunday they would pick on her to pray, and then she wouldn't say nothing. And then one little young man walked up to her and said, ma'am, why do you keep getting up making a spectacle out of yourself every Sunday? Don't you know they're just poking fun at you? Don't you know they're just making fun of you? Don't you know they just put you up there to make you the joke of the Sunday afternoon dinner? Don't you understand they're just making fun of you? You just get up, you don't say nothing. She says, I know they're making fun of me, but what they don't understand that when I get up to pray, I'm not talking to them. So when I talk to God, they don't have to hear what I have to say, because sometimes I don't want you to know the level of intent or the intensity of the storm that I'm going through, because if I told you, you couldn't handle it, no way. But when I talk with God, anybody here have had to talk with God about a level 10 storm? Have you ever had to talk with God about something that was beyond the capacity to control with your hands? It got too hard. And if I told you, I'm just wasting time. But when I talk with God, he immediately moves and he calms my fears and tells me, chill out, I got this. And that's what God does when he's beside you. And I know there are some of you that have been in some fights and in some wars that people promised to fight with you, but when the fight started, they ran. But you got a God that won't run from fights, but the enemy will run from God. One more question. Where is God at a time like this? Where is God in Mama Haston's life? I'll tell you where he is. He's before you. Then he's beside you. Then he says, when I pull you through the valley, I'll be behind you. Because verse 6 says, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And here it is, I'll dwell in the house of the Lord forever. But the interesting thing that you'll understand is that, listen what he says in verse 4, yea, though I walk through the valley. You see, you got to understand, valley time is not your destination, it's just a part of your trip ticket. You got to go through some dark times, but that's not the end of your journey. You got to go through some tough times, but that's not the end of your journey. You got to go through some transitions, but that's not the end of your journey. But the part that you need to be shouting about is that where she is, she says, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, because when I trusted God, he was before me, he was beside me, and now he's behind me. He says, I got some guard dogs that's back there, that if anything try to slip up on you, because a true soul soldier never looks back. A true soldier keeps going forward. So God says, as you keep your eye on me, I got your back. You going out of here today with your head lifted up, knowing that the God she trusted in and that she's resting with now didn't let her die in the valley, but she made it home. That's interesting. Came from Alabama, comes here to stay, goes back to stay down there to be cared for, and then come back home. Her life resembles our journey, that God will let you come full circle. And when God is with you, can't nobody stop you. So the question is, what is she saying now? I made it. I made it. I made it. And one of these days, you too gonna make it. And the interesting thing that I want you to think about as we go is that, child of God, your valleys are temporary, but being at daddy's house is permanent. When you finally get home, it's a fixed address. Did you hear me? You see, sometimes communities change, and sometimes the state, they want your property. They'll force you out and force you to move. But the good thing about God is that when you get to daddy's house, they can't put a highway through there. They can't do no reconstruction there. They can't put you out there. No. When you get to daddy's house, it's a fixed address. So, mama, I won't tell you good night, my sister. Sleep on and take your rest. You fought a good fight. You kept the faith, and you finished your course. Well done. Father, thank you for your word. Thank you for your people. Thank you for this family. Continue to give them comfort, give them strength in days to come. The moments that will come, I pray that you would manage them by your grace and your sovereignty. And be as you've always been, and that's be God through dark times. Don't let the memory get the best of them, but let the memory minister to them. That those that are with you are all right. Yes, we miss them humanly. We miss them personally. But one day there's going to be a great reuniting. And we too are going to be at that fixed address. And thank you, God, for these who have come today and those who are watching by live stream. Bless today. And if there's one that don't know you, the pardon of their sin, may they get to know you as their shepherd today. Because there will be struggles that sheep can't handle. They need a shepherd to handle it. And God, as you've done it for us, do it for the person that's sitting or standing next to us. Turn things around for them. Lift heavy burdens. Dry tears. And we trust you to do it. In Jesus' name. Amen. Brothers and sisters, I do want to remind you that if there are friends and loved ones that didn't get a chance to come to the service is on live stream. You will go to Temple Baptist, E as in Edward, C as in Charlie. They'll be able to see the service in days and years to come. We're going to be praying with you, and we're going to be praying for you. The intimate will be at Lakeview Cemetery on Euclid Avenue. I'm going to ask that once you exit the building, if you would go ahead and get in your cars, cut your lights on and your flashers, and the gentleman on the outside will help get you flagged and get you lined up. And we're going to go to the cemetery. Our services don't end here. If you need us, please give us a call. On behalf of Mr. George Horn and myself, Pastor Veal, who are the CEOs of the House of Peace Funeral Home, we pray that things have been done to your satisfaction. And we want to present this memorial blanket complimentary on behalf of us to you for trusting us with Mama Josephine. We thank you for entrusting her in our care. We're going to be praying for you. If you need additional copies of the blanket, we can get you one. Just give us a call at 216-341-7000, and we will get you a copy. God bless you.
So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as ye know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord.